Australia vice-captain David Warner has scored 20 centuries in 66 test matches. Australia v England, the first Ashes test date 2327 November time 00:00 GMT venue Gabba, Brisbane coverage Bulby Ball test match special commentary on BBC Radio 5 Live Sports Extra, Radio 4 LW and the BBC Sport website. Live text commentary on the BBC Sport website and app. Full coverage. Australia opener David Warner says that England all-rounder Ben Stokes has let a lot of people down. Stokes, 26, was arrested in September on suspicion of actual bodily harm after an incident outside a Bristol nightclub. With the first Ashes test due to get underway on Thursday at 00:00 GMT, Stokes remains in the UK awaiting the result of a police investigation. "It's disappointing for the England team and the country," said Warner. "I would have loved for him to be out here because I know what a competitor he is. He's a world-class player." England will be without Stokes for the first test in Brisbane, with the Durham man made unavailable for selection by the England and Wales Cricket Board until further notice. "He knows he's made a mistake and it's about him getting that respect back from his players and fellow countrymen," added Australia vice-captain Warner, who himself was suspended in 2013 after punching England batsman Joe Root on a night out in Birmingham. On the prospect of Stokes joining the England team at some point during the Five Test series, the left-hander added, "Firstly, it's up to the English police. If he does come out here, well, wish him well. We're all sportsmen and we're trying to achieve the same thing, that is to win. I wish everyone good luck." Warner only faced two deliveries in the nets on Tuesday after suffering a neck injury during fielding practice. He said that his neck felt stiff, but that it was unlikely to prevent him from playing in the first test. From England's perspective, former captain Alistair Cook said the tourists have accepted it is unlikely that Stokes will join the tour. "You can't always pin your hopes on one guy," said Cook. "If there is a bonus of him making the trip at some stage, that would be great, but I can honestly say it hasn't been spoken about in the changing room." Lion comments made Cook chuckle. Alistair Cook averages 49.53 in Test cricket in Australia on Monday. Australia off-spinner Nathan Lyon said he hoped the hosts could end the careers of some of the England players. Cook, who was England skipper when they were beaten 54 years ago, said the comments made him chuckle. "It's really strange," said the opener. "Nathan was the first person I saw when I got to the ground and I had a really nice 10-minute chat with him. He was asking me how my kids are. All the talking will stop very quickly and it will become a normal series after about 2 hours of play. We'll be talking about cricket rather than the off-field stuff." Cook is one of five members of England's 201,314 touring party set to play at the Gabba on Thursday, with Australia fielding three survivors from 4 years ago. In that series, England's batting was decimated by Mitchell Johnson, who took 37 wickets. "Mitch was outstanding, one of the best periods of bowling I've ever faced, and he was backed up by Ryan Harris and Peter Siddle," Cook, 32, added. "But they are no longer playing, so in that sense it is irrelevant." England have won four of the past five Ashes series. You can look at that how you want.